All right. Well, hey, everybody. It's me and Jamie O'Neill. We're doing it the old school way here. We have a video of a video.
But right.
Great to see you again.
Great to see you, Bill. I'm looking forward to being there on Saturday.
Yeah, absolutely.
Grand Rivers. Can't wait.
It's going to be so much fun. This will be your third appearance or fourth appearance?
I think it's my third, because the first time I came there was with Andy Griggs and Ryan White.
Right.
Then the second time I came by myself,
right,
and performed an acoustic show. And this time we're doing something a little bit different, which I'll let you start the ball rolling on that.
Yeah, you mean with the songwriters workshop?
Right, exactly.
Yeah, that's going to be during the day. What did we say? 12 to 3, I think.
12 to 3, depending on how many right. How many great aspiring songwriters we have that sign up.
That's right.
And we always start with kind of talking about how I came to be a songwriter and right. what tips I've learned along the way.
Right, right.
But really my favorite part of it is hearing each one of the, you know, songwriters that come. What I love to do is have them either bring a song, bring right. a guitar or a keyboard or whatever they need to bring. It
right.
could be a tambourine, it could be a cowbell. As long as they can sing along with it, and then they sing me their original song that they're either working on or one that they've finished.
Gotcha.
And I kind of give them tips on that
right.
and I help make them get their song to be the perfect thing that they want it to be, that the best, you know,
right.
version of their song, by helping them along. And some people are, you know, a verse and a chorus in, or some people have the song completed, or maybe it needs a bridge or something
right.
like that. So we kind of help with people, like, you know, that just want to make their songs stronger, I guess, and learn about songwriting and that kind of thing. So it's really fun. The times that I've been involved, it's a blast.
And then
in the nighttime, of course, we're performing a show, so that's a completely different thing. And I'm hoping
yeah.
that one of the songwriters from the afternoon, we're going to choose somebody who will actually perform that night with me.
Yeah, that would be really cool. It would be a real, you know, a real honor for them, I'm sure, to do that. Not only get to hang out with you during the day and pick your brain and all that good stuff, but then to get to perform with you on stage would just be so cool.
Yeah, it's really fun. It's really fun. And sometimes they prefer, it depends on what someone wants to do, but a lot of times someone would rather just sing with me on one of my songs, or sometimes they want to sing their own song and
right.
be up there doing their own music. So
right.
I leave it totally up to them.
Well, that has always been something that I've noticed, just, you know, as I've known you over the years and have watched your career, you've always been a big believer in helping others, and especially other songwriters. That's a really cool, you know, not everyone wants to help everyone else get along, and you always seem to have wanted to do that. That's a really neat attribute that you have. I really appreciate that.
Well, thank you. I mean, a lot of times I'll get DM'd on Instagram and meet people that way, or meet them in a show.
Right.
And have someone come up and give me a tape of their music. And sometimes we end up producing it in the studio and
wow.
being fully involved with their career and kind of
right.
mentoring them at an early stage. And,
right.
and or other times, you know, we just stay in touch as friends. And some of them have ended up realizing that being in the business wasn't for them,
or yeah.
they didn't enjoy the process,
right.
and maybe they're a mom now, and,
right.
And that's great too, you know. And a lot of times when they're really young girls, I end up becoming good friends with their moms,
right.
you know, and
right.
staying in touch with them and,
yeah.
and hearing all about their lives. So that's pretty cool. It's a great job to have.
Well, and sometimes, you know, it isn't, this life isn't for everybody, and sometimes they need someone to go, yeah, you need that encouragement, or yeah, you need to probably go maybe not do this or do something else or whatever. So that encouragement works both ways, and that's really awesome that you're there for them.
Yeah, I think, I mean, the thing is, if you wake up and you think, no matter what anybody tells me, I still want to do this, and I'm going to forge my own path, and I'm going to do it my own way, and
right.
then nothing will stop you.
Right.
Then I think, you know, sky's the limit. But if you're the
right.
kind of person where, you know, maybe things are going to bother you, or you realize that, you know, it is such 100% commitment, and
right.
and it's like you've got to have that burning passion to perform.
Right.
Or maybe if you want to just be behind the scenes, that's okay too. You know,
right,
I mean,
right.
we have great universities like Belmont. And,
sure.
There's all kinds of places in Nashville, like NSAI, where you can come and learn about the business side of things and the business as a songwriter,
right?
Publishing and PROs and things like that. So
right.
It's a really great business to be in. Nashville's sure. fantastic. It's expanding, and it's not too far from Grand Rivers, which is really cool.
Yeah, we love it, and we love all of our Nashville people. You know, we've had you, of course. We've had Brian White. We've had Andy Griggs down. We have Mo Pitney coming in October. So we want to be, you know, Nashville's back porch or something. You know, this is really cool that we're that close. So
I love that.
I need to trademark that. Nashville's back porch. Yeah. There you go.
I really like that. That should be the phrase that you have right underneath Badgett Playhouse.
Right,
sure.
Right. Absolutely.
Let's hope that what happened last time doesn't happen this time. Do you remember what happened last time?
Oh, your husband's hand.
My husband's hand and the cream that was recommended, the deep blue cream. Remember that incident?
I was late to the show that night, literally. What was the cream, the deep blue cream or whatever? What happened?
Oh, man. That's a... I'm not even sure if I can tell that story.
Oh, okay.
without it just... You know, I think you have to, I think it's a rumor that's probably still circulating throughout Kentucky, but let's just say that the deep blue is akin to like, you know, that the Bengay tingling, mentholated, whatever cream it is, and he got it in the wrong spot.
Oh!
Yeah,
it's all coming back to me now. Maybe I had shut that out of my head or something, but I do remember.
Yeah, he's still got PTSD.
how now will he be playing with you this time as well?
Yes.
Okay.
Yep.
And last time he started and his hand or something started to hurt, but he was able to power through and it was a great concert and everybody loved it.
Yeah, it was really a lot of fun. And, you know, the thing is, you guys always have a great crowd. The people are always amazing and supportive. And they're just funny and they just join in. And, you know, it's so great because a lot of times when we play, people are really serious.
Oh,
and
nice.
I always think it's more fun. The more fun you can have at your shows, the better off everyone, the better time everybody has.
We really do. And then, you know, we've got all of our regulars and then we'll have all of the people that are following you from, you know, from your fan base or whatever. So it's kind of a neat night when you look out there and you're like, these are some people that wouldn't normally come here, but you bring a whole new, you know, realm of people to us. And that's a real, real cool thing for us.
Oh, well, thank you. I always love that. It's always great to meet new people and for you guys to have new people that haven't been to the theater before. Can you hear my dogs barking?
I can. And we got people going, you know, nuts here, so it's okay.
Yeah, we have three dogs. And
you have Maltese dogs, don't you?
We have, one's a Morkie and the other one's Shih Tzu mixed with Maltese and then the other one's a Maltese, so.
Well, we're big Maltese here. Well, I say we've only had one, but she's not with us anymore, but she has a place in our hearts forever, so. But we love Maltese.
Yeah, they always do. It's so sad.
Yeah.
Like, you know, it's like losing a family member.
It is. Small dog people just, if you're not a small dog person, you just don't understand.
Right. Yeah, they're definitely like your babies.
That's right. That's right. Well, it sounds like you've been pretty active lately, like you've had a pretty full touring schedule as well.
It has been a pretty busy year. Yeah, it's been really great. I've been working on a brand new record.
Awesome.
Which I'm really excited to get new music out there.
Yeah.
And I've re-recorded my hits. And so it's a package of
old
songs mixed with new songs.
Okay.
And that's the first song's coming out at the end of October, and then
great.
The album's coming out in like February or March of next year. So
okay.
I'm excited.
Well, I'm always so impressed by guys like you and like I said earlier, like Brian and you know, Andy, you guys are just like road warriors. You're just still out just doing it. I mean, week in and week out, it's so awesome. I mean, you obviously love what you do, and you know, the old joke, you do it for free, but, you know, it doesn't hurt to get paid too, I guess, so.
Yeah, I think the time on stage is not what you get paid for. It's everything else that comes
That's
along with,
exactly you know, right.
Getting to the time on stage, for
right.
sure.
Yeah, I'll do that for free. It's another stuff you got to pay me for. That's right.
Exactly.
Well, cool. Well, anything else that we can look forward to on Saturday night? I mean, you and your husband, you said some new songs.
New songs off the new record.
Yeah.
We'll be playing. We play some fun covers.
Okay.
And, of course, the songwriting workshop during the day is
going
to be really cool. And so we'll be there from 12 to 3, and then the show's that night at 7, is that right?
That's correct. Doors
will
open.
Plenty of time for people to go get something to eat in between.
That's right.
And Yes, yeah, it's going to be really fun.
If you get a chance, we'll try to run you over and show you. You know, Patty's isn't quite open yet, but there's a new place across the street that Patty's also owns called T. Lawson. So I'd love to go over there and show it to you real quick. It's a really neat place.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
That sounds nice.
Yeah, it's really, they did a great job with it. I mean, they put the Patty's touch on it, and it's amazing. So you'll really enjoy it.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
That's great. Looking forward to that.
Absolutely. Well, just thanks again for coming back and seeing us, and we're looking forward to having you out this Saturday night, 7 o'clock at Badger Playhouse, and we'll open the doors at 6:30. And if those aspiring songwriters out there want to spend the day with you and get all the wealth of your knowledge from all your years in the business, they need to get online and buy that ticket as well. And that starts at noon and goes till about 3. So that'll be a fun one.
The tickets are on badgerplayhouse.com, right?
Yes, that's correct. They can go on there and click that and it'll come right up. Or our Facebook page, they can find it there as well.
Awesome. Okay, well, I can't wait to see everybody.
Yeah.
Please come out and see us.
Okay.
Please come to the songwriter workshop. It's going to be a whole lot of fun. And okay. Then join us that night for the show.
Are you bringing the doggies with you, or are they going to stay home?
Are they allowed?
I don't, you know, that's a good question. I think you've asked me that. Now that I say that, I need to find out. We'll see what we can do.
I don't think they are. Yeah.
I think my wife would love to see those dogs, because it'll bring back good memories for her of our little one. But anyway, well, we'll find that out for you. But well, that's great. Well, we're so excited to have you, and it's going to be another great night at Badgett with you, and we look forward to having everybody out.
Thank you so much.
All
thanks,
right.
Bill.
Thanks,
see you soon.
All right, take care. Okay. Bye-bye.
You too.